Make sure to subscribe to this channel for more videos like this.
That happens here. Now, it doesn't mean that those summer thunderstorms are over, however. In fact, there is a threat of flash flooding, and we did see some flash flooding yesterday. We want to take you here into North Carolina on Monday. That is a car. Do you see that? That is a car right there. Mother and her child and two others had to be rescued from this car as that water just rose up so quickly. You see how they have it tied so it doesn't move. Between 4 and 5 inches of rain fell in the area in nearby Smithfield, North Carolina. Another water rescue for a mother and her two children. So there was two separate incidents. She was rescued, but the children are still missing, according to a press conference that happened minutes ago. Florida, right? They go flying all the time here. Yeah. I'm just happy there was no garbage in it. Or how many times do you just put like loose end garbage in your garbage can?
And then it tumbles out once it tumbles over.
And I'm a stickler.
My mom was a stickler for that too, Jen.
Yeah. You're a stickler. Everything has to be in a bag.
Yeah.
Even if it's in
because
just,
of that very reason. I mean, look,
you don't even need a storm like that in order to blow it over, and then there's just trash everywhere. All right, let's have a look at what's happening behind me. I mean, you don't even have to be a meteorologist to know that we have explosive storms. Look at this satellite imagery. We're going to go underneath. This is an indication. If you only had satellite, you would say, wow, there's big storms happening, and we can show them to you here. Anywhere from Oklahoma to Arkansas, look at the trail of flash flood warnings. If you are within one of these boxes, and essentially this is multiple boxes laid over each other because there's so many warnings, there's flash flooding that's imminent or it's and or occurring. Why? Well, first of all, places like Little Rock, 14 inches above average since the start of the year. Fort Smith, 12 inches above average since the start of the year. And it's not just since January. In August, a lot of rainfall. Fort Smith, 5 inches above average just for the month of August. So the ground is nearly saturated from excessive rain during the month of August, and now we're getting more on top of it. And everywhere you see one of these icons, that is an indication of some sort of water rescue, road being flooded, homes being evacuated. We'll take you into Oklahoma City, showers and storms here, basically racing from west to east. And as we hop over and show you what's happening in Little Rock, storms are coming to you. Hot springs over 5 inches of rain here from these storms. Everything will be blasting into Little Rock. But Jen, that's not it. It not only lasts as we head into the afternoon and evening hours, but into tomorrow as well. So Dallas and even points south towards the coast, you have to keep an eye out for this. Jen, we might get a nice little shelfie coming out. I don't know if you saw that outflow boundary.
Tomorrow morning, we'll be talking about that right here. All right, so it looks like you don't get a break, right? We've got more rounds of strong storms set to fire up across the Southern Plains area. Places like Oklahoma City, Dallas, Little Rock. Sorry we keep saying your name, but it's in the forecast. Downpours are possible and heavy rain could cause flash flooding and ponding on the roadways. Sorry. So, Tevin, let's time it out. I mean, is there an opportunity to go out, run an errand, get outside without the rain?
Yeah, I think there's a chance, but there's only a chance because there's a
flash flooding. And so you can imagine now a day later, we're still seeing the same amount of rain falling again. So here you go. There's your flood alerts through Thursday morning. We have flood watches out for portions of Oklahoma, including Oklahoma City, also down into parts of North Texas around Wichita Falls. Then as we get to the east, including Arkansas and even the Dallas-Fort Worth area, we do have a flash flood watch that is out until Thursday morning as we're going to have multiple rounds of rain. We call it training thunderstorms or training showers, and that just means one after another, like a train, one comes in, another one comes in right after it, and unfortunately that causes some pretty big problems with our flooding. This is the area that we're likely to see flooding problems anywhere from the Dallas Fort Worth area up through Texarkana, Little Rock, even Wichita Falls. They've already seen so much rain. Dallas, you're about 10 inches above normal for the year. So the soil very saturated in this part of the country, even into Arkansas as well. So it's not going to take too much to get some flooding going. And unfortunately, even some trees down as those soil is so saturated. Now, here's a look at our thunderstorm threat today. Along with the flash flooding, you could see the potential of some severe thunderstorms as we head throughout the afternoon. Future radar shows you there's that cluster of storms that's rolling in from Oklahoma into parts of Arkansas. So Little Rock, you are not done yet. And then this afternoon, we get some storms firing up in the Dallas-Fort Worth area and a big batch of showers and thunderstorms rolling through overnight into early Wednesday morning. So look at all that rain, especially north of I-20. We'll be looking for that threat of severe weather as well as flooding, and that'll also go up across the Red River. And then you can see throughout the rest of your Wednesday, we'll have some scattered activity. And then tomorrow, Wednesday through Thursday morning, we will still have that concern of flooding. So unfortunately, this is not over quite yet for Oklahoma, Texas, or Arkansas. Alex?
Well, let's
Drivers are having a tough go of it this morning right around Fort Smith and just south in Arkansas. This area has just seen about 5 or 6 inches of rain overnight. Same thing actually south of Oklahoma City. We're getting some flooding reports there as well. By far, though, this area, thankfully it's on the move, has really seen some big rainfall and big rainfall rates, which has led to the flash flooding. So let's zoom into that. At Fort Smith, we are at the moment getting a bit of a break, but look how we've got more rain coming back into the area. So even though it's not as heavy as rainfall rates is just what we just saw. This will be an area to avoid travel if at all possible, simply because we already have flooding ongoing. Spots that haven't flooded yet could because of the rain in the area. Then watching this forecast for today, I-40, you get a couple of rounds coming on in right through the afternoon. And then once we hit about 4 o'clock, watch what happens down here into northern Texas. These thunderstorms really start to flare up. They could be severe. Big hail possible. That could do some damage to your vehicle. So take the other car today, perhaps. But also overnight, watching for some big rain coming in here. This is a kind of stormy night that will keep you awake. Steph.
Well, the fallout from the derecho in Iowa that flattened millions of dollars worth of crops in August is even bigger than some can imagine. This video after the storm hit on August 10th. Iowa is requesting nearly $4 billion in disaster aid. And there's another element to this that could affect millions of Americans. The Weather Channel's Dave Malkoff has that story.